Hey, howdy guys, Connor McCaskill here, and today I want to talk to you about why I think the X-T3 is still worth picking up with the X-T4 coming out in just over a month. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and begin. So when the X-T3 came out in September of 2018, it kind of blew everyone's minds with the specs that it was packing inside. So the X-T3 is boasting a 26.1 megapixel sensor with a processor that enables it to shoot 4K 60 and 1080 120 frames per second. And those frame rates are a major reason why a ton of people picked up the X-T3 when it first came out. Additionally, the Fujifilm X-T3 is capable of producing an F-Log 4:2:0 10-bit internal image, which is super impressive. But not only that, it's able to do 4:2:2 10-bit out, which is absolutely gorgeous. The Fujifilm X-T3 also has a few other amazing features, including a weather-sealed body. We have dual card slots, which is really nice. Face detect autofocus with eye tracking, which I find to be extremely accurate. Beautiful film simulations like Eternal and my personal favorite, which is Across. And their tilt screen, which personally, I don't prefer this style of flip screen over like a flip out screen, but I do know that this is preferred by photographers. So with all those specs said, is the X-T3 worth picking up with the X-T4 just around the corner? Well, before I answer that question, let's quickly go over what the X-T4 is going to have over the X-T3. So besides all the things that they share, which include the same sensor, the same processor, and most of the same film simulations, the X-T4 is going to be featuring 5-axis IBIS, which is a really big deal, especially for anyone trying to shoot handheld without a gimbal. Additionally, it's gonna have a much bigger battery, which was one of the things about the X-T3 that most people disliked was the battery life on the X-T3, and the X-T4 is going to correct that. Another really big thing coming with the X-T4 is going to be a flip-out display, which is massive for YouTubers. Additionally, the Fujifilm X-T4 will have an extra film simulation in terms of the bleach bypass film simulation, which I have to say, I quite like the aesthetic of this simulation, and I'm curious to try it out for myself. So again, I ask, is the X-T3 worth buying with the Fujifilm X-T4 right around the corner? I have to say, absolutely. I think the X-T3 is still a very powerful camera in the year 2020. Being able to shoot 4K 60, 4:2:2 10-bit out, and 4:2:0 10-bit eternal, it's able to do 120 frames per second at 1080, and it features the same sensor and processor that the X-T4 has. So I have to say, if you do not need 5-axis IBIS or that flip-out display, the X-T3 is going to be an amazing deal. Plus, now that the X-T4 has been announced, the X-T3 has dropped in price from, I believe it was $1,700 when it came out in September of 2018, and now it's $1,300. I imagine it's only going to go down once the X-T4 officially starts shipping, so you might be able to pick up an X-T3 for around $1,000 or less, especially on eBay. I really think that the X-T3 is going to shine, especially for photographers, because I understand that a lot of photographers are upset with the flip-out screen on the X-T4. Now, personally, I love it, but I am definitely more video-focused. However, I have heard that this type of tilt screen on the X-T3 is much preferred by photographers because they want to keep their eye in line with the center of the camera. So all in all, I think that the X-T3 is going to be an amazing deal in 2020. Definitely a camera worth picking up, especially if you want to save a little bit of money and still get a lot of the amazing features that the X-T4 possesses. Guys, if you agree and you think that the X-T3 is an amazing deal going into 2020, make sure to drop me a like, or if you're just super excited like I am for the X-T4. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Consider subscribing if you did. And as always, thanks for hanging.